Welcome to the channel. Now, this video is the first in a playlist that I'm going to start adding to the channel. And the whole theme revolves around maintaining your motorhome or campervan and doing certain jobs or repairs or how to do certain jobs. And tips that I've picked up along the way as I've just done work on my own van, be it on the habitation area or on the chassis or engine and so forth. So first up is how to remove and install the engine battery on a Fiat Ducato based motorhome. Now, I'm going to give you two very good tips related to the battery in this video. One is related to the refrigerator when it's running on 12 volt power. And the second relates to when you think your battery is dead, but in fact it's something else. And this is exactly what happened to us. This is a really great tip because it's a common issue with Ducatos where the battery is concerned, and it has all the hallmarks of having a dead battery.
Okay, so this here is the replacement battery. So you can see it's 12 volt, obviously, 95 amp hours. My previous battery was 100 amp hours. That's just, the duration, the energy duration of the battery. Like, so you've got 95 amp hours in this particular battery. It's 850 amps. That's like the cranking power, power it will generate to start the engine. Remember, the purpose of a starter battery is essentially just to get the engine going and started. So that's your cranking amp power. I think it's normally called CA or CCA. So this is the battery that's going in instead of the other one. The other one could possibly have a dead cell or something. And the other one is reading 12.65 at the terminals on a multimeter. But on occasion, on the Heimer control panel, I saw the other day, for example, it was just reading 1.3 volts. So hopefully this will solve the problem. Okay, changing the battery or the engine battery on your motorhome is not that difficult. So don't be overwhelmed by it. You don't need to go and pay anyone to do it for you. It's relatively easy. So here we have the negative terminal. Positive one over there. This bracket, which is holding it in, also needs to come off, and this red thing will need to come off as well. So you start with the earth or the negative terminal. So we're just going to, just a second, push this out. Okay, now that will loosen this clip here. Now that's quite easy. That's your first one off. Okay, I'm just going to get this out of the way of the terminal, and we'll go on to the next one now, if I can manage it. I'm trying to hold the phone in one hand and the cable in the other. Okay, in my situation here, I've loosened this, but the cables are coming here, and this is kind of in the way, so I'm actually going to remove this first. So we just need to undo this bolt. This comes in two sections, I believe, so just do that now. So just to show you, the bolt here is, on my one, is 13 millimeters. Just do that. Okay. Let's just undo this. Got your bolt, just put it away safely so you don't lose it. And just pull up this kind of up here. Okay, so top section. Oh, this is a nuisance. Okay, I'm gonna have to cut these cable ties here. So, okay, what I'm going to do, I have a snip here. I'm gonna snip these two. Okay, so these cable ties here, this one here was a complete and utter nuisance. It was just so tightly wound, wrapped around the cable here, that I just had to be very, very careful. We've got those cable ties off. So let's just remove this first. So just keep in mind how it comes out. So these kind of wrap around the battery. Let's just put that aside, keep it there. And this is inserted on top of the bolt. It's kind of a clamp. You just slide it backwards this way and then up like that. So to get it back in will be the opposite. So just push it back like that. Okay, now let's disconnect the earth here. So I've already half disconnected, so we're just gonna pull that up out of the way and just get it away from the terminal if possible. Now I've got lots of other of these cable ties here, which is another nuisance, so I don't wanna take off anymore. So we've got this off, and I might wrap it in something just to keep it away from the terminal. Okay, so I'm just gonna pull it off here. And just maneuver these out of the way. So we're just trying to create a bit of space for ourselves so we can get the positive terminal off. So we'll just move these out of the way. Now I have to keep putting down the phone to do this, so, but it should be self-explanatory. I've just put this towel here. It's inclining to fall back on the terminal, so just to stop that happening. So you can see the nut over there, that's the nut for the positive terminal, so we just need to loosen that. And I'll just go get a spanner now. Okay, the nut on this positive terminal is 10 millimeters on my one, so. Okay, so I've got a 10 millimeter spanner, so I'm just gonna loosen that. I know you can't see it now with this block in the way, but. Okay, you can see the nut there now. It's 10 millimeters, so we're just gonna loosen that, okay? Now, just incidental to this, when I first got this van, our fridge would not work on 12 volts, which is off the alternator, the battery 12 volt circuit while we were driving. And I discovered later that this particular fuse here was actually faulty, it was actually broken. And when I replaced that, the fridge started working again. So keep that in mind if you ever have a 12 volt problem with your fridge, it could be this fuse here in the engine battery compartment. So anyway, I'm just gonna loosen this and then we'll unscrew this red thing. Okay, I've loosened the terminal here. So next up, we've just got to take off this red clamp there by unscrewing these two screws. Now don't be intimidated by all these wires. Once this red thing comes off, it will all come off the terminal. So let's just do that. So again, I'm just gonna do two of these and I'll put the phone down, okay? Try to get a screwdriver underneath it to get it to come away. Now be careful, you don't want to break it either. Gently, as gently as you can. Okay, I'm gonna have to put the phone down again because it's a bit awkward with one hand. Okay, just to show you how it was secured. So you've got these two lugs which go right down into the clip there. So just be careful. Just put your screwdriver maybe under here and under here, and that should pull up. But just be gentle with it, you don't want to break it. So let's put that aside. So the final step is just to remove this whole bracket. So this should just come right off, which it does, like this. Okay, and now you're free and we can lift the old battery out. So let's just push this out of the way and get the old battery out. Again, I have to put down the phone, so for obvious reasons. Okay, this is the old battery. It was out. It was a bit of a challenge to physically lift out because quite a few of my cables had been cable tied. See, there's a lot of cables, so it actually was quite cumbersome to get out. The corner of the battery was getting caught, so it's probably not going to be easy to get it back in as well. Just remember, positive on this side, negative on this side. Don't do it the wrong way around, or else you'll have to take the battery out again. So let's do that. Okay, we've got the new battery in place. Just make sure when you drop the battery down that you don't catch it on any cables, and it's got, you know, good clearance all the way down, that no other cables are pinched or anything like that. Okay, so just hooking up is just the reverse of doing things in reverse order. So obviously the last thing we did was to disconnect this. So let's connect that and put the red tab in as the next step. One other thing, when you're screwing this in, do you see these kind of square washers there? Make sure those square washers are sitting square to the terminal, not at an angle, not at a kind of a diamond angle, if you know what I mean, but just square down on both sides. We've got it on. Now, even though that's tightened, it still wants to, it has a tendency just to slip up, so you need to put that in. So I repeat, just be careful you don't break this when you're taking it out, and I will screw this down. Okay, the final step is to secure the earth or the negative side to the negative terminal. Okay, so let's just do that now. Don't forget to secure this and snap this shut. Okay, that's more or less it. So it's essentially just covering up again. Obviously, we'll check it to see if the van is starting, and there you go. The final step is just to return these brackets here. So let's just do that. This one goes in here. Actually, we'll put it on. Okay. And then we'll put this one in. A little bit. No, have I done this the right way around? I think I have. Okay, it's getting dark now, so just be sure to bolt this back down with the 13mm socket. Okay, so finally you just put the cover back on. Now you can see, if I just go here, the hinges just slip under there and you just close it down. So here you've got two bolts that go in and they look like this. I didn't show you this at the start because I already had the cover off. So you need a 13mm socket just to bolt those down. And you're done. You just put your, well, you're almost done.
Having bought a new battery and going to the trouble of installing it, as you saw in the video, the van still refused to start. Luckily, all this happened at home, so it wasn't that much of a crisis. Now, here's the battery tip that I promised you at the start of the video. If you look at the negative terminal on the screen on the right hand side, you'll see, or you'll remember from the video, that it's the cables are clamped to this terminal with a kind of a plastic clamp that snaps shut. As it so happens, these clamps are not always as secure as they're meant to be and sometimes can work themselves a little loose and lose that contact with the negative cable. And this is exactly what happened in my situation. I reinstalled the old battery and just started fiddling around with the negative terminal contact, and then suddenly everything just roared to life. So if you find yourself in a situation where your battery appears to be dead, try this first. This could very well be the problem, especially in a Fiat Ducato. Now, last October, we were in the village of Giverny, which is just outside Paris, and we were about to leave, and I turned the ignition and it was just nothing happened. It was completely dead. And I turned around and my wife had her head in her hands in despair in the back of the van. But because of this experience, I was 95% sure that this was the issue. And it turns out that's exactly what the problem was. So my point is that it's very important to take the time to know your vehicle, because it can really get you out of a difficult situation once you're familiar with issues like this. And this is something I'm going to talk about in an upcoming video.